You know, I completely agree with that. Like, you see a lot of things in the forums about comparing the PDC to BDO, and I really don't believe it's even a comparison, because the style of game we play, the game that is presented to you, and how hard it is every week, is truly about being the best and being paid. I believe the BDO, this is my opinion, it's not Tommy's opinion, BDO is a growing ground, just like the ADO is in America, to come in to be better. I think the Tui Guard, I'm just glad I made the World Championships last year, because it puts me in a position to have one if I can play, because playing out of America makes it very difficult to do those things, because the prices, as we all know, the price of airfares go up a lot this summer.
The thing is, I'd come in and I'm just interject there, you know, lots of talk, as you say, about the BDO. A very little known fact is that the first Darts Council board invited Dr. Croft to sit on it. And Ollie sat with us for 2 days discussing this, and then sent it. I've still got the actual letter in the house, sent a one sentence letter saying that he wasn't interested. We've tried on numerous occasions since then to even fund the BDO to some extent. But, you know, not. It's really is a case of over my dead body with Ollie.
Yeah.
And that's not meant nastily. That will never change. And people will say that there's people on this side, myself being one of them, because the guys tried to ruin us. But, you know, that's gone. It's one under the bridge. We are where we are. We want to move forward. And you're right, we do need the BDO, because we have never, ever been a replacement for the BDO, ever.
Yeah.
But it's not, you're right, you can't compare the two, because it's not like for like.
It's right. And that's what I'm saying, it's like, I don't get to do things in America anymore because I'm in the PDC, but that doesn't begrudge me, because they're doing what they do and I made my choice. And my choice is to be, try to be, one of the best players that you can be. And this is where you're going to be. If you want to be a great player, you're going to be in the PDC. It's up to you whether you're going to make it. What do you think is going to happen in the next couple of years with the PDC? Do you think we're going to grow to more events? Are we going to go more global? Because I know, like, we're going to Australia for a little bit. I know, like, I travel a lot with Soft in Asia. I talked to a gentleman since he's talked with the PDC to bring the PDC to Asia. Is that the future of the PDC?
That's exactly where I'm going. We've pretty much reached saturation point in the UK. We won't seek to, over the next couple of years anyway, unless some massive investment comes in, look to do anything differently within the UK. But our target markets are obviously the Far East, Australasia, and still the USA, which, you know, it's been a hard sell over there, as you know.
Yeah.
But we are still there, and we're still shooting there. We've moved one, as you know, to Atlanta. The US Open's gone to Atlanta this year, but that's a double header now in Atlanta, so it's worth going to. And I'm actually going over to run that, so because the draw is on the day, you know, it wouldn't be fair to meet Jay with that. So, you know, those are our target markets. And, you know, all of it's driven by television. You know, at the end of the day, television is the god. I remember there's a game called Kabaddi, which you probably haven't heard of, but it's a Pakistani game played in dust bowls. It's like Tiggy with a ball. They filled the Royal Albert Hall to watch that because it was on Channel 4, which proved to me that television really does master everything.
It's funny that we talk about the television, because obviously most people I talk to, and the way I view the game is, I don't play for money. I mean, obviously if you're winning or you make TV, you're making money. But truly to be a great player, I think you play for pride, and like what Phil does. I mean, Phil can never make another dime, but he's still driven to be the best player in America. Now you're talking about America, because that's one of the projects I'm doing, is actually doing a pilot right now to make darts different in America, or sellable in America, different than how BDC runs it over here. Do you think, I understand that the game has been born and bred in PDC or in the UK. Maybe when we go to other countries, do we need to change how we present the game? Not so much how we play the game, but do we need to present the game maybe different?
Well, you know, we're always open to any innovations that anyone may come up with, but we have to keep the integrity of the game, obviously. Especially if it's a ranking event, we which goes towards qualification for the World Championship and all the rest. We're not averse to trying anything differently. You'll notice, I mean, I'm responsible for every one of the formats that we've done, and I've changed it around to try and give every single tournament its own entity and its own identity, so that when you talk about the World Match, the World Grand Prix, rather, you know immediately that that's double starred. It's known as a double starred tournament. So yes, we are amenable to changing things around. We do, however, need help from the people like yourself who are on the ground, because you may have a lot better ideas than us. But everywhere we've been previously, David, we haven't met help. We've met enmity in that any WDF affiliates have stood in front. They've actually, their mandate is to spread the game worldwide, and they're actually preventing it.
Right. You know, honestly, I'm here on PBC, and the things I'm doing in America trying to have a sellable game is to have it that. I believe if we can have fishing on television, the best shaft, the best well, why can't we have the best dart player on TV? Yeah. Tommy, thanks a lot for your time.
Pleasure. Good luck.
Thanks.
Lovely to see all of the American people at the end of the day.